Hey, what's up, guys? Thank you so much for clicking on this video. My name is Will Ross. I am a 21-year-old college student trying to achieve financial freedom. If you would please like this video and subscribe, it would really help me out, and I'm trying to grow this channel. In this video, guys, I want to talk about five cars under $10,000 that are heavily modifiable and, for the most part, are pretty reliable. So I think you know where I'm going in the first one. I've talked about this car in plenty of other videos, but it's the 350Z, and I talk about it so much because it's such a great car. Look, Nissan made tons of these cars, so there's not any kind of shortage. You can find some on Facebook Marketplace, you can find some on Craigslist. Anywhere you find your cars, you can find one for under $10,000 with a manual transmission. You're roughly gonna be looking for the 100,000 mile range to the 200,000 mile range. They typically last around 250 to 300,000 if you really take care of them. But yeah, this is my number one. But because Nissan made so many of these cars, the aftermarket support is absolutely insane. You can do so much to this car for not that much money. And you can turn something that looks pretty base, like a base 350Z manual, into a sick wide body Panda drift machine. The 350Z comes in a 3.5 liter V6 that runs around 306 horsepower base. And in a smaller car like the Z, it really puts power towards the back end that makes it an amazing drift car. But you can do whatever you want with this car. This is something you could turn into a missile drift car. You could turn it into a drag spec, I guess, and it's just all around fun to drive. I would recommend getting the manual transmission just because it's more of a fun experience. But yeah, this is my number one, the Nissan 350Z. My number two, I'm going to talk about the BMW E36 or the Series 3, specifically a 1980 to 1990 version. It seems like in the past couple of years, this has become a really popular car to buy and then fix up and take to car shows. So this is my number two. You can definitely find some for under $10,000. Typically, if you want to look for the lower mileage, I would say you're looking more at the $15,000 to $20,000 range, but we're talking about project cars here. I think under $10,000 is very reasonable. And I'm gonna throw up a screenshot here of a Facebook Marketplace find, just to show you some proof that you can find one for under $10K. This is the epitome of the golden era of BMW and the 80s and 90s era of cars in general. The body style is just classic and iconic. I think it's just a beautiful car to begin working on, and it's something that's very satisfying that you can turn into something that everybody's gonna turn their neck looking for on the road, at car shows, etc. These things are also great drift cars. I think the base comes in at around 189 horsepower, so not crazy, but if you're not looking to race this or, you know, throw it on a drag strip, it's definitely a drift build-esque chassis that you can kind of do what you want to. I mean, personally, this is my favorite on the list. If I had to pick any of the cars on the list, I would pick this one just because I love the look. I love the front lights, even though they're not pop-up. I heard the manual transmission in this car is very satisfying. Shift, I haven't given a chance to drive this car, so I don't really know what the experience is like. But from what I've seen from an external view and how these look and how people have modified them, this is definitely one of the best looking cars on the list, and from what I've heard, one of the most fun cars to drive on the list. So my personal favorite on the list, this number two, BMW E36. At my number three, I'm gonna say the Ford Mustang, specifically the Fox Body era, which is around the 1985 to 1990s. This is just the epitome of a classic American muscle car. If you're not a fan of JDM, you're not a fan of turning anything drift, you want to really put as much power to the rear wheels as much as possible, I think the Mustang Fox Body is a great platform to start on. This is actually probably the cheapest car on this list, and not only can you find one under $10,000, you can find one under $5,000. Again, I'm gonna throw up a screenshot here of a find that I found on Facebook Marketplace. I think for better mileage and better condition, obviously you're gonna be looking towards the $7,000-$8,000 mark, but either way, under $10,000, definitely a great platform to start on. This car doesn't come base at an insane amount of horsepower with the 3.8 liter V6 wrapping in around 120 horsepower, but these have incredible engines that you can modify very well to be a fast machine that would beat the modern day Mustang GTs. And with the money that you're saving on this car with a $10,000 budget, you can definitely do that. So if you want to go classic America muscle car, I say the 1985 to 1990 Mustang Fox Body is a perfect way to go. In the previous video, I talked about G35s being a great car for under $5,000, and while you definitely can find a G35 for under $5,000, if you have a larger $10,000 budget and you still want an Infiniti G platform, I would definitely go for the Infiniti G37. In my opinion, this is a 370Z made for a businessman. If you want the same body style, if you want the same engine, basically a skeleton of a 370Z, but you want it more sleek, you want it to be more luxurious, maybe leather, the Infiniti G37 is definitely a way to go. This is a very slept on sports car, as most people kind of focus towards the G35s, 350Zs, 370s. The Infiniti G37s really get looked past, and I don't know why. I love the way these cars look, and I love the way that they look after they've been modded. So while you can definitely find one under $10,000, if you have that extra leeway of $1,000 to $2,000 and you can go up to maybe $11,000 or $12,000, I would suggest doing that and finding a base G37 with less miles, maybe in a manual transmission. This car, in my opinion, from what I've heard, is the most reliable on this list, so that extra $1,000 or $2,000 that you're spending out the gate is going to be worth it in the long term if you plan on keeping it for a while. I'm going to throw some screenshots here to show you what a modded G37 looks like. To me, the base model looks pretty cookie cutter sports car, luxury, sedan-esque, but modded. They look absolutely insane. The power into these cars is pretty good. Base, these things run a 3.7 liter V6, 325 to 330 horsepower engine. And in my opinion, it's the best supercar on this list. A lot of people don't know about it, and I think it needs more attention. So G37 is my number four on this list. The last car on this list might shock some people, but it's gonna be the Dodge Charger. The Dodge Charger is the last car on my list. It is an amazing American and muscle car. Much like the Mustang, you can do a lot to it. These things can have an amazing amount of horsepower if you tune it right, if you do the right engine mods. And they have one of the sleekest looks on this list. I really love the way these cars look. Base, I don't really love the way it looks, but aftermarket has done miracles with this car. Getting new wheels is a huge thing, new fender flares. These things are insane once they're modded. Obviously, Dodge and the SRT line has insane capabilities of running insane amounts of horsepower. You don't need to get an SRT model to start building this car to be an insanely fast car. My point is that Dodge has an amazing amount of mods that you can do to all their cars to make them insanely fast, and the Dodge Charger is definitely an amazing chassis to start with. Here's a screenshot of a Facebook Marketplace find for under $10,000 that you could buy. This car is very slept on, and I really hope that they make a resurgence here in the next couple years, because I love the way they look. That's gonna wrap up my list for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you did watch the entire video, I really appreciate all you guys' support. I love seeing comments and stuff like that. I love making these videos in my free time. I don't really have a lot of free time, but it just gives me joy and it makes me happy to put out these videos. So I really appreciate y'all's support. So I'll see you in the next one. Peace.